Welcome everyone. I'm Akash Deepdhar. I have been the part of the community since the last 1 year. I have been contributing in infrastructure, badges, classroom, packaging, Q&A, mentoring, in and out. Today, I'm accompanied with Ramya Parimi, who has been in this community since the last 9 months. And I'm excited to talk to you about the new Fedora websites and apps revamp that we have been working on recently. This takes the already existing Fedora websites team and expands its vision to a greater horizon when we include maintaining of applications as well, which the community uses. To tell you more about who we are and the things that we have been up to, I would pass it on to Ramya. Ramya, over to you.
Thank you, Akash, for the introduction. Hi, everyone. Thank you for taking your time to listen to our session on Fedora websites and revamp, team revamp. So a little bit about who we are. So firstly, I would like to introduce myself. I am Ramya Parmi, and I've been contributing to Fedora since September 2020. And I first started with contributing to the DNI docs. And then I wanted to explore more horizons and then in Fedora, and then I wanted to also explore web development. So that's when I came across Justin, Akash, and Nasir, who were already working on Vault. So I did join them on that, and then it was quite exciting. And then we all quickly realized that we can do a lot more. Just not just working on more, but a lot more. So since we all, like, especially Akash and I, like, we do share this common interest of working on web development. So we wanted to do, like, bring together other folks sharing the same passion. And so we wanted to, like, actually maybe thought it's a good idea to have a special interest group or something. So with that, Justin was in the beginning quite supportive and encouraging about it. So he gave us a kickstart about what can be done and all that. So we were working on making a platform for folks who share the same passion of web development to join as a special interest group. So while we were working on that, we started getting a lot of, like, visibility in the Fedora community, and we were quickly joined by Marie and Matthew, who were really supportive and directed us towards actually making this special interest group into a team. And then along with them, other folks from other different teams, like Musk from Red Hat Open Source Program Office and Pingu from Community Platform Engineering. So our effort was, like, it started getting more folks into it, and then it was getting bigger. So that was quite an exciting journey. And a little bit more about who we are. So basically, the idea is to actually revamp or reboot the Fedora websites team. So until now, Fedora websites was mostly about, like, they are mostly static websites, and it was mostly about updating them for every release party and stuff. So we thought it will be really great to actually make a new addition to the static websites by including the dynamic applications that are widely used across the Fedora community, like Mode, which has the meeting logs, and then FedoCal, which has the calendar events and all that, and then badges. So we thought it will be really great to actually include this dynamic applications, which are widely used. And we also thought that it will be really great to actually revamp them as well, probably modernize them so that, like, they are used with more ease and stuff. So we thought that that would be great. And then while that was happening, we were actually, like, wondering what will be the great place for us to be home. So we first thought that maybe we should make this as a website's web dev sick, because it's web development sick. But then folks from the community mentioned that it's not just a special interest group, it can actually be a team with a common effort, a common passion of, like, working on web development and stuff. So, and then we thought maybe we can be a bridge between infrastructure, like the operations and the development. So then we thought maybe we can put it as DevOps team. And Matthew and Marie and a lot of other people, folks from federal community said that no, it actually makes sense to actually have the Fedora websites and apps, obviously, because we'll be working with websites and apps, right? So now we are actually trying to like hoping that our forever home will be like somewhere between the infrastructure, websites, and a lot of random apps that are dynamic applications that are used in the Fedora community. So now that we have all that, the basic thing laid out, we're actually looking for new contributors to join us and grow with us and then make this effort into a big thing. So now once we have that, like we do also have a really good vision laid out, and I'm going to pass it on to Akash so that he can give more information about our vision. Over to you, Akash.
Thanks, Samia. That was a good experience that we had over the names and the teams that we had to jump towards and through. So in the process of proposing one of my ideas as one of the candidate projects for Fedora's participation in GSOC, we came to a realization that it's not just about this application right here that I was proposing, but there are applications in the community that the folks use day in and day out. They could use some more love, and in terms of maintenance and modernization. We have multiple applications like Moat, Badges, FedoCal that we use added to all what we already maintain with every release, the websites for the spins and everything else. We would obviously provide a landing page for new contributors, not just on the basis of websites, but in terms of mentorship as well. We are excited to give them a starting place for the community. So if there's anything or issues that they would want to work on to get started with, or just to meet new folks, they're free to come and join us. Web development is one of the mainstream skills, and I do see that a lot of folks would be willing to join us, and they would be willing to stay back contributing with us in a long run. Along with that, the starting point for newcomers, we're also trying to make sure that the existing contributors, they feel empowered when they're communicating across multiple teams. Like Ramya mentioned about the infrastructure team that we communicate with every now and then. So there would be other parts of the project as well, so websites. So we will be continually talking with the design team as well. So we want to make sure that the existing contributors feel empowered when they interact with the other parts of the project as well. Now, looking into all these things that we can amount to and the tasks that it does seem to be a massive amount of work, doesn't it? So we decided to go ahead and propose it as an objective to Fedora Council. And we do have an existing ticket, and it's a discussion in progress. Let's see how it goes. So the thing that we have in front of ourselves is the objective model that the project is a part of, and you can obviously take a look at it. I will drop a link to it in the chat box. Now that we have discussed about the things that we have been up to and who we are, we'd like to hear more from you. So the next slide talks about the ways that you can contact us. Over to you, Ramya.
Thank you, Akash. That's great explanation. So now that you all know about who we are and what's our vision and our objective proposal, so if you want to know a little more about us, do join us on our weekly meets, which are for now happening on Friday, but we are definitely going to move to that on a different day. So do join us on our weekly meets. And also we do have a Matrix channel. So come join us. Let's do great things together. Yeah, that would be really great. Yeah, and it's Q&A time. Don't be too harsh.
Please feel free to ask any question that you have. We'll love to interact with new folks, and we'd definitely love to answer them.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm just going to drop the links that we mentioned.
Whoa, so we already have one of the prospective contributors to our team already. Samir, awesome. I'm really looking forward to look, you know, to meet you. So Edward has a question. If there is something you think need to be right from zero, will you do it? Definitely. Even if it is something that needs to be done from scratch, it would definitely require some planning. But with the contributors, which will slowly drop into our team, I think that is something that we can do in given point of time.
Yeah, we do have that as one of our like objectives down the lane as well, to start to make an application from the scratch. So yeah, that's in the agenda, like down the lane. Obviously for that, we need more folks. So again, more contributors, come join us.
So Ashlyn has next question. Are there any aspects of development that you need more people for, like back end or front end? As a matter of fact, we need people for all rounds of development, be it back end or front end. So if there's anything or any way that you think you can be of assistance, please feel free to join us. And it's not just about assistance. If you want to drop in to say hi, the chats are all open. The existing applications in the infrastructure, they make use of backend technologies like, I think it's mostly Python. So the frameworks like Django, Flask, Pyramid. Pyramid is, I think, what's used in badges. So these are things that are used in the backend side of things. So if these things make sense, if they ring a bell, then please feel free to join us. I think Ramya would be able to tell more about the front-end side of things.
Yeah, so for now, we'll be having like more information about what frameworks we'll be using and all that once we get a good inventory of what applications are actually out there that we can work on. So I think for now, like that's from what I think, though, it will be really great to have like an idea of frameworks like React, Vue, which are used for like host, like dynamic thing of the application, and other like obviously HTML and CSS.
Awesome. Moving on to the next question, Thalia asks, what level of experience would be good to contribute? As a matter of fact, we are quite open. It's not really important for you to be knowing a specific technology in order to contact us. We are open with the mentorship part of things as well. So if you're interested, and if you feel like that, yeah, this is something that I would really like to work on, then we believe that you know, when you contact us, we can surely hitch ourselves up, find some place to find some time to contact, and then we'll be finding something or else that you can be of help. So there is no laid down good level of experience to start from. Any place is a good starting point. That is what we believe.
Totally agree with that.
Yeah. How about you go ahead with the next question, Ramya?
What happened to the packages website? I don't know how to answer that. Do you know, Akash?
Christian, yeah. Even I'm not very sure of this answer. So if there's anyone in the chat section who knows an answer to this, please feel free to answer this.
That's a great question.
Yeah. The next question being about websites and app team working on a particular big jobs at the moment.
I mean, like for now, at this point of time, we are still doing the groundwork of getting the objective proposal moving and then all that ground stuff. But once that's done, we do have like more lined up, definitely, because that's what we were working on earlier. And then we thought like, and then we decided that it would be a great idea to actually start this revamp and stuff. So yeah, it's Moat.
So Moat would be one of the first of many applications that we'll modernize in due course of time. And Christian, like he mentioned, that I think the sources of the packages is something that is a next step forward regarding this. Correct me if I'm wrong. Because packages.project.org is something that's not turning up at my end as well. So mostly it has been moved on to something else. Gokul asks, which would be the platform where we would be communicating regularly in order to stay updated? Okay, Gokul. So I believe that the links to the matrix rooms that we always communicate in have been dropped in the chat. Apart from that, we always have weekly meetings that happen on Fridays. Not exactly the best day for meetings, but we are still trying to, you know, make sure that it happens on a much favorable day. So that's how you can reach out to us. The links are in the chat. You can obviously find them. Ramya, how about the next question from Edward? How about you take it? Directory listing Apache Fedora team. Yeah, we do have Fedora Bootstrap, which is based on the Bootstrap 4.3.1. Not the really latest and the greatest of all Bootstrap, but yeah, it looks good and it managed to get the work done. And I think that it should be one of those things that we can do if we sit with discussion with the design team and get with a good proof of concept, then we can definitely move forward with that. So yeah, it's something that we would like to work on down the line. Thanks, Edward. We'll wait for some time if more questions turn up, if there are more things in the chat box. Yeah. And as always, I think the slide deck has been pinned. The link of it can be found in one of the messages that people has put. So please feel free to open that up. If there are any parts of the deck that you believe that we were not clear about, we'll be very happy to go through it once again. Apart from that, the links to the places that you can contact us are there on the chats as well as on the deck. So feel free to reach out.
Yeah, thanks, Marie. I'm going to pin that. So if I can pin that. Yeah, I'm trying. Oh, well, I think only organizer can. Oh, no.
No, you can pin it as well. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Was I on mute at one, some point? Marie just
yeah,
said
you were.
Just, what did I miss? What part did I miss being on mute?
I think I was able to answer that. It was Edward's question about the theme for the directory listing, because the way it's been listed, the way it's shown, it could use some more love. It could look a bit more appealing. So total plus one to it, Edward. Would definitely like to work on that. Yeah, I think there are no questions. So I think we can close this. Thanks everyone for hearing out. Thanks for attending this session. Really appreciate you being here. Please feel free to reach out to us on the Matrix channel. Feel free to join us on the Friday meets. We'll definitely schedule it to a better time, but bear with us until that time. Thank you, everyone.
Yes, thank you so much, everyone.